Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. SpaceX posted a tweet saying NASA has ordered 6 additional space station resupply missions from SpaceX. Dragon will continue to deliver critical cargo and supplies to and from the orbiting lab through 2026. Shell Lindgren posted a tweet saying, Freedom. Crew 4 will fly to the International Space Station in a new Dragon capsule named Freedom. The name celebrates a fundamental human right in the industry and innovation that emanate from the unencumbered human spirit. I wanted to share some pictures from Julia Bergeron of the Falcon 9 booster B1051 which recently flew. She said, up close and personal with veteran booster B1051, this beast has completed 12 flights and is the current life leader of the Falcon 9 fleet. There was some information tweeted by Kristen Davenport about SpaceX. One of the tweets says, interesting but not surprising, Gerst says that on Starlink mission, SpaceX continues to iterate on Falcon 9 using it to test limits. We are actually changing some of the thrust characteristics of the rocket to actually get more performance out of it. The other tweet says, as for the lagging chute on SpaceX's Dragon, Gerst says they did a rigorous review but it's just the way they inflate when you have 4 chutes deploying at once. Even on this Axiom return we might have another lagging parachute. And if we do, it's just a function of the design. There was some Starlink information posted by Jeff Faust. His first tweet says, in a SmallSat constellation panel, SpaceX's Jonathan Hofeller says the company is building close to 8 Starlink satellites a day at its Redmond, Washington facility. Vertical integration has cut the cost of its user terminal by 2/3 from the original version. In another tweet, it says he reiterates past comments that SpaceX has talked with geo operators about offering Starlink satellites for a hybrid network but haven't found an approach that works. There was an interesting tweet posted. It says, with the help of high-resolution satellite imagery, it appears SpaceX has shipped 2 Falcon 9 boosters from the port of Long Beach. Gavin Cornwall also posted a tweet about this saying, I've tracked this barge and it would appear that SpaceX shipped 2 Falcon 9 boosters from the port of Long Beach to Vandenberg Space Force Base yesterday. The SpaceX Axiom 1 mission with private astronauts going to the ISS is scheduled for April 3rd and this article was posted about it. It says, NASA officials gave the green light Friday for the first all-commercial astronaut launch to the International Space Station on a SpaceX rocket as soon as April 3rd. But the astronaut launch could be delayed a day or longer to give priority to a countdown test for NASA's Space Launch System Moon rocket on the neighboring launch pad at the Kennedy Space Center. There's an article posted about a company called PSN Group that will be launching a satellite on a Falcon 9 rocket. The article states the PSN CEO said, we have already entered into a contract with a satellite manufacturer from the United States, Boeing Satellite Systems, to build the new Santa Lima satellite. We also have entered into an agreement with SpaceX to launch the satellite on its Falcon 9 rocket. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. The work on the wide bay and the production yard has been continuing. There was a tweet posted with pictures from Roberts Road and the Starship pad being built at the Cape. It says SpaceX is rapidly progressing with Starship work at Cape Canaveral. SpaceX posted a tweet saying NASA has selected Starship for an additional mission to the moon with astronauts as part of the Artemis program. Michael Sheets posted a tweet with further delays to the environmental assessment from the FAA. He said the FAA is delaying the environmental assessment on SpaceX's Starship facility by another month to April 29th from March 28th. In another tweet, he also posted, for now, the FAA review is not holding up SpaceX's Starship development as the company is at least a couple of months away from when it would need the environmental assessment to be complete to request a license for the first orbital launch attempt. The Starship 24 nose cone barrel section has been receiving some heat shield tiles. Chris Burgin from NSF posted an interesting tweet saying Mary spotted the cargo door pathfinder being moved. Starship's opening cargo flights are set to include huge amounts of Starlinks taking advantage of the vehicle's impressive capability. In addition to this, he also posted a tweet saying, another photo from Mary, currently assigned as Ship 24's nose cone barrel section. The nose cone of Ship 24 also continues to be worked on with it back in the fabrication tent. During the week, Booster 4 was hooked up to SpaceX's crane. Crews were seen working on the booster transport stand for B4. The Super Heavy Booster 4 prototype was then lifted out of the orbital launch mount. The booster was then placed inside the transport mount. The crane was then disconnected and the booster moved. The Booster 7 prototype was spotted outside the high bay briefly before being moved back inside. It was then once again moved out of the high bay, and then again was moved back inside. Finally, I want to share the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website again. Currently, there are closures scheduled for half of this coming week, with tomorrow, Monday 28th, Tuesday 29th and Wednesday 30th. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, known as Boca Chica Gala Nikantsuini, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.